Welcome to So Very Easy. My name is Laura, and Prairie Points around quilts, garments, handbags, any crafts and hobbies are really cute. Now, there are two different ways we can make them. We can make them a traditional way, or we can make them sort of a way that I find is a whole lot easier. There's no measuring involved, and we just get to cut and make those prairie points. Prairie points are little series of these triangles. Now they can be done on an outside of a quilt like binding. They can be put inside so they're pointing in towards the quilt. They can be put in the middle of quilts. They can be put on bags, garments. They can be used anywhere and they can be any size. There are two different ways of making them. A prairie point is a little folded fabric that makes this point. Any size square will make a prairie point. We will fold it once on the diagonal, twice on the diagonal. That's going to put all the raw edges together on one side, the big fold on the other, and those two open folds. Prairie points can be made one at a time, but they also can be made with a long strip of fabric. I have the prairie points on a panel. This panel is from Susie B's. The panel also comes with a book panel. And I'm going to put this easy method of putting prairie points around the book. It'll just be easier for the camera to see everything. But the method is exactly the same for any project you are going to make. To make this method of prairie points, we do need the front of the project and the back. So it could be a quilt front and a quilt back, and they need to be the same size. And we will need a piece of batting that is going to fit the project. To start with, we will need the front piece of the quilt, and in this case, is going to be the front of the book. I will be making a double row of prairie points, which means I'm going to have the two different colors go all the way around. This method is a very easy method, and all we need to do is decide what color fabrics we need for our prairie points. For this project, I am going to do the green as my main prairie points, and the yellow will be my secondary points. Start with a piece of fabric that's the same length as the project you're working on, and I'd recommend starting anywhere between a 3 to a 4 inch piece of fabric. And the width is not that important. We just need the exact size. I would recommend that all of the fabric is pressed. And for the piece of fabric that we're going to do the prairie points, give it a good pressing and starch it. The starch is just going to make it easier to press after. Once I have the length, I need to determine the size of my prairie points. And there's no math involved in this. Just take that piece of fabric, fold it again, and again. Now, if this is not a size that you like, instead of folding it in half, we can fold it in threes. If you have a long strip for the quilt, you're just going to keep folding and keep folding, always matching up those edges till you get a size that you like. In my case, I'm going to press it once, make sure that the edges stay together. Press one more time, make sure your edges stay together, and press. Once it's folded and pressed, we need to do some trimming. Find the area where you have one loose piece, and take that piece and just fold it back on itself. If you have a thin pair of scissors, this is a great time to use it. We're going to put that scissor in between all of the folds, and just cut a little bit past this little corner. Pull that scissor against the fold and cut just a little bit past that mark. It's only cut a little bit more by about 2 or 3 threads. And I'm going to cut all of the layers, just pulling that pair of scissors against the fold right to that mark. And do the second side. Trim all the way to the edge of this corner. Go past that little corner by 2 or 3 threads. So what we're looking at is the top piece. All of those little squares are cut, but we still have the folds along the bottom. When we open it up, we have all of those cuts made, and a piece of fabric is holding all of these cut squares together. Each one of these little pieces where they've been cut will become the prairie points. If you're doing a single prairie point, you can just start folding these. But if you're going to do a double prairie point, we're going to use this as a template. So I'll be having the one prairie point with that second color in between. Start with a piece of fabric, the same size. Lay those two fabrics together and cut right where those cuts have already been made. No measuring involved. Just use those cuts on that previous fabric. The only difference between the top point and the bottom point is we need to be short one square. So we can cut off one square. So just remove one square. Now we get to make our points. All of our strips need to be folded in the same direction. It won't matter if you start from the left to the right or from the right to the left, but they all need to be consistent. Take the one corner and fold down. That corner up at the top is going to be a tight corner with the seam coming down. You will have a little extra here, and that's just a little extra breathing room. And press that seam down. I like to do all of them in one direction first. So I'll take the second, match up that corner, and press. Continue folding so all of your points are sharp up at the top. And press them all going in this direction. Once all the points are going in one direction, we're going to refold. So that top point is coming down. So we have a fold here, a double fold, and all the raw edges are pointing in. We need to do that to all of those points, both with the main fabric and the secondary fabric. As I press these down, I find a little starch is going to help hold them down. If you don't use starch, they're just going to stick up a little bit. The prairie points are now done. The reason I like to start with 3 or 4 inches gives me a little bit of a handle. If I had a very small piece of fabric, these would shift very easily. And that handle is nice to hold on to. And with this method, I don't know how big my points are going to be, so I do like to have some extra. Now that we have both the main fabric and the secondary fabric done, we're going to combine the two. Pick up that second piece and lay it right over top of the main fabric. The secondary points are going to go in between the first points. And we can line them up from behind if you find it easier to see. Shift and make sure that those points are somewhat in the middle. I did start with the same width of fabric, so I know I'm going to be able to match up those edges. And once they're lined up, we can just pin those layers together. Now flip it over. We're going to take that back fabric, lift up one of the points, and lie it on top of the second one. So that back point gets lifted up, the point goes down, and it lays over top. And do that for the whole strip. Once all these little flaps are putting over, we can do a row of stitching as close as you can to that raw edge. And that's just going to hold all these points down so they don't get in your way. So that stitching line is right as close as you can to that edge. And this is the complete row ready to stitch on to the quilt or whatever you're using. Those prairie points are going to fit perfectly along that edge. Now I need to do the short edges. There's a really easy way of putting these points onto our quilt or whatever we're working on. Lay the strip of prairie points in front of you so that that wrong side of fabric where we have that big handle is facing up. The panel or the quilt or whatever we're working with is wrong side down. We're going to just slide that until it gets right to that little edge where all those prairie points are. Where all those prairie points are laying is where that edge is going to lay. The fabric is the same size. We have the wrong side and the wrong side showing. And that edge is following the edge of the prairie points. And pin those layers together. When we look at the corners from behind, we can see the fold of that prairie point go right to the corner of that fabric. With the wrong side facing up, stitch a quarter inch right along the edge. So you're going to use edge of that panel or the edge of your project as a guide, not your handle of the prairie points. Once that row's been stitched on, those prairie points are on the project. And we can trim off that handle. Cut off that fabric right along that seam. Be sure to put on both of the long sides first, match, and stitch that quarter inch and trim off the handle. Once the two sides are done, we're going to be able to put on the short sides. Same thing. When you look at it from the right side, the edge of those prairie points are going to match. If both sides were exactly the same size, the prairie points would match up along this top. But because this is a no measuring method, chances are this side will be different than this side. But you're not going to notice it when we turn it right side out. So match up those edges, match those layers together, and stitch that quarter inch. The prairie points can remain pointing in towards the quilt. If that's the case, you're just going to be able to quilt it as normal and put a binding on it. But in this case, I'm going to use the prairie points as binding. So I want them all to be sticking out all the way around. So I'm going to add my backing and my batting on all at the same time. My backing piece of fabric needs to be the same size. Then my batting will go over top. We're going to sew it from the top. So we're going to be able to follow our stitching line. So we're looking at the batting, the back piece facing up, and the front of the quilt facing down. Pin these layers together. This method really works best for a batting that is thin and one that is not going to get caught on the feed dogs. Once all of those layers are pinned together, we're going to be able to stitch following that last row of stitching. We need to sew around the project, but we need to leave an opening. So those layers are all stitched together and I have my opening, I'm going to trim off the batting and trim my corners. Trim that batting as close as you can to that edge of stitching. So take a little bit of that corner off and do that to all four corners. We can now turn this right side. And when those corners come out, we do have cute little corners. Take time and smooth out your layers, both on the front and the back. Close up that opening. When this has been turned right side out and all of the edges have been pressed, we have a beautiful finish on both edges. The prairie points have taken the place of the binding. I'd recommend putting on a walking foot and stitching right along this edge. From there, the project is done and you're going to be able to quilt it the way you want. For the board book, I am just going to do a little serpentine stitch around each of these pictures. That's just going to secure them together. If it's the large quilt, well, you can quilt it however you'd like because the layers are already together. Because this is a book, we do have additional pages. Sandwich them together the same as you did the cover. Turn it right side out, press it, and repeat that same quilting. I'll go through some quick notes on how to finish this soft book. When we put those layers together and the book is closed, we should have all the pages in the right order. And they are normally numbered and the directions will tell you how. I do have a video on how to put together these soft books. I'll put a link in the description. line up that center, and stitch. I will be finishing off the quilt the same way as I did the cover in the book, and it's going to be a fun quilt that will match the board book. And those prairie points really do add such a fun border. That strip method really does work quite well, and it's quick, easy, and no measuring, so we can get that project done. Thank you for joining me today on Sew Very Easy. Feel free to subscribe, and as always, come on back. Let's see what we're sewing and talking about next time in the sewing room. Bye for now.